Today, two teams begin their journey toward WNBA greatness. I got
Indiana has won the WNBA championship for the very first time. You can't take the heat.
The Minnesota Lynx have taken back their title.
They're going to the Twin Cities to play for a title.
Is headed back to the WNBA Finals. Welcome to the 2015 WNBA Finals presented by Boost Mobile. In downtown Minneapolis, Minnesota, it's game one between the Western Conference Minnesota Lynx and the Eastern Conference Indiana Fever. Hey everybody, Ryan Rucco alongside the Hall of Famer Rebecca Lobo. Happy to be with you on this Sunday afternoon here on ABC. The WNBA Finals, probably a destination we could have predicted for Minnesota. Certainly not a destination that anybody predicted for the Indiana Fever.
I don't think people knew what to expect from Indiana coming into the season. Wouldn't have been surprised if they didn't even make the playoffs. Why? Because they lost legendary head coach Lynn Dunn to retirement. Well, Stephanie White stepped in and has done a marvelous job for the Indiana Fever. They started out slow, new players, new system, but come July in the All-Star break, after that, they started playing as well as anybody in the WNBA. A tough team with their backs against the wall. They know how to win, and that's why they're here in the finals.
Yeah, won two road game threes to get to this point. Meanwhile, Minnesota got off to a scintillating start, but dealt with a lot of injuries, some new pieces. Their road ended up pretty tough to get here too.
Yeah, they had an up and down season a little bit as well, but it was a bit of the rich getting richer come the All-Star break for them when they acquired Sylvia Fowles, one of the best centers in the WNBA. Dealt with some injuries. Two of their more veteran players, Simone Augustus, Lindsey Whalen, end of the season missing time. But they are back now in the playoffs, have played well, and they're here back once again in the WNBA Finals.
Maya Moore in the finals for the fourth time in 5 years and caught up with our Holly Rowe.
Maya, this is a team that beat you in the finals once before. What are the lessons you learned from that last time that you will take into today's game one?
Just play extremely focused, confident, hard.
This is a team that thrives on defense, this Lynx team. What are the keys tonight for you defensively?
Just playing locked in together as a team, rebound and run.
Thank you, Maya.
Thanks, Holly.
Well, Maya Moore is ready to go. So are these fans. It's game one of the finals. Lineups, tip, coming up next.
The WNBA Finals 2015 is presented by Boost Mobile and in part by the State Farm National Bureau of Assists. No one assists alone. And the Quesarito and Volcano Quesarito Big Boxes. Grab them at Taco Bell.
Getting ready for game one of the WNBA Finals between the Fever and the Lynx, and the locker rooms are wired for sound.
Every little thing that we've done to put ourselves in a position doesn't change because of where we are. That's how we continue to find success. That's how we continue to grow and get better. Go out there, play your asses off, and enjoy this moment.
You're jockeying for position up on top of the mountain together, right? What are we going to do? You've got to have each other's back when you do that. You've got to throw punches. If you don't throw a punch, you can't win. We've got to make sure we come out there first five, let them know what's up, all right? Here we go.
Let's go. Let's go.
We'll find out what's up with the Indiana Fever's starting lineup, the Eastern Conference champions, led by Tamika Catchings, a 14-year veteran in the front court with Arlena Larkins having a beastly postseason, and Marissa Coleman, backcourt of Breon January, a four-time all-defensive team player, and Shanice Johnson. For the Minnesota Lynx in the finals for the fourth time in the last 5 years, Lindsey Whalen, Simone Augustus joining Maya Moore, and then Rebecca Brunson and Sylvia Fowles crash the glass on the inside for a team that has had five consecutive 20-win seasons. When you talk about this building, you talk about an incredible home court advantage. Minnesota 19-2 all-time at Target Center in the playoffs. Their last loss came against these Fever back in Game 1 of the Finals in 2012, a series in which Indiana upset Minnesota in four games. Fouls and Larkins will jump it up. The white towels are a-waving, and we are ready to go with the WNBA Finals underway as Indiana wins the tip. Crowd will stand here until Minnesota's first bucket. Indiana trying to get theirs here. Shot clock all the way down to five. Nice lobbed entry pass, and Larkin's able to finish it.
Great job by Erlena Larkin. She is so effective inside, got a switch defensively, so she ended up with Rebecca Brunson on her. Keep a match, an eye on the matchup of Rebecca Brunson guarding Tamika Catchings on the other end of the floor.
Moore, a quick pop, around and off, and Larkin's a good box out of fouls. Indiana plays with pace as you see the quick trigger there, and Larkins comes flying in, try to create the second opportunity, and she may get it after Sue Blau consults with Kurt Walker, and she will.
Elena Larkins averaging just under 3 offensive rebounds per game in these playoffs. She's not that big, right around 6'2", but really has a nose for the basketball.
And she averaged just 3.5 points a game in the regular season, but averaging almost 10 points a game in the playoffs. Catchings way off the mark. Moore saves it nicely to Whalen on the floor to control it for Minnesota. Whalen using that Moore screen. Whalen has struggled a bit this postseason, battling several injuries, as is Simone Augustus. Fouls on the offensive glass, had it stripped away as she brought it down.
Anytime you're going against an Indiana defense, you know they are going to be hands in there, scrapping at the basketball.
Catchings a little bit off kilter on each of her two attempts.
A little bit eager. She's been in the finals before, but there's still going to be nerves for every player.
The postseason's all-time leader in points and rebounds. Maya Moore may someday catch her. And she puts home the first bucket of the afternoon for Minnesota.
Defensively, when you go against Maya Moore, you're trying to make things as difficult as possible. But you know what? Even when you make things difficult, she can drop 40 on you like she did in Game 2 against Phoenix.
A deciding Game 2. Moore leading the postseason, averaging just under 28 points a game. The MVP of last regular season, the MVP of the 2013 WNBA Finals.
Right now, Marissa Coleman will be defending her, but you'll see a few different players on Maya Moore throughout the course of the game.
January, halfway down, no. The rebound kept alive there nicely by Shanice Johnson.
Breon January, so important to the success for Indiana on both ends of the floor. How is Lindsey Whalen going to do trying to defend that speed and quickness that you see right there?
Well, Maya Moore made whatever Whalen did moot. Good help there coming over with the swat. So plenty of time to operate on the shot clock for Indiana. This Fever team winning two game threes on the road to get to these finals after dropping game one. Coleman, no. And Indiana has missed their last 6 shots. Neither team with much offensive rhythm early. Fouls has plenty of size on Larkins and goes around her but can't finish. Johnson the rebound. Indiana looking to push. Johnson forgot to take the ball with her. Sort of a sloppy beginning to game one.
Got a few things in play right here. It's a sloppy game, yes. Both teams have had time to prepare for one another, so their scouts are on point.
And time off as well as Moore gets loose backdoor, and she scored the first 4 for Minnesota. Minnesota champions in 2011 and 2013. Lost in the finals in 2012 to these Fever. As Larkins goes down and trying to call for a timeout, she will take one with 8 on the shot clock. A lot of physicality early on, and Maya Moore finding an easy one, which is something Stephanie White does not want to give up too many of.
Yeah, Maya Moore doesn't get a lot of open looks very often, and when she does, she is going to finish. She has been the offense for Minnesota so far in this game.
Two leading game one, Maya Moore with all four of those points, Rebecca, but they usually don't come easy for her.
This is a player who has made a living by making contested shots. When you go back and take a look at their series against Phoenix, DeWanna Bonner, long, one of the best defenders in the league. Maya can elevate over and get the shot off. Here, create space the whole time looking at the basket. She just needs a split second to get that shot up and finished again. And then finally, she can use footwork here. Little step back dribble, eyes up the line, able to hit as well. It was amazing what she was able to do. She had 29 field goal attempts in that game. 26 of them were contested, only three times, two of them because players trying to avoid foul trouble. Was she able to get an easy shot?
Meanwhile, not many whistles early, in fact, none. Larkins wanted one there. Moore had it stripped off of her out of bounds as Catchings got to her, and that's going to be fun to watch throughout these finals. Moore and Catchings, two of the real stars of this league.
The more physical, Ryan, the refs allow this to be, that plays into Indiana's favor. They're a team defensively that really likes to get in you.
Moore on a steal there. With January all over, here's foul. Drives the reverse side and got fouled by Larkins. And Sylvia Fowles will go to the line. Elena Larkins hit with her first personal. And Sylvia Fowles, who was acquired in late July for moments like this to take Minnesota over the top. They'll call the foul on the floor. Interesting.
And that's going to be a tough matchup for Elena Larkins because Sylvia Fowles is so much bigger inside.
Moore, that was a contested look. Fowles would chase down the offensive rebound. Four rebounds already for Sylvia Fowles.
The key for Indiana will be to prevent the pass from going into Fowles in the first place. Larkins with the side front here trying to keep the ball out of her hands.
Lob inside, taken by Catchings, the crossover freezer. Catchings, chased by Brunson, will stop and get fouled or travel first. She walked. Indiana turns it over.
Right idea, though, from Tamika Catchings, because you know Brunson is a shot blocker, will leave her feet. She just, there you see Catchings, didn't have her feet set.
Catchings a little discombobulated offensively in the early minutes.
Yes. Indiana's gotten some good shots, a couple of them from Catchings, shots that they were making in the last round. There's nerves at play here. 4-2, it's not been very pretty, and I think a lot of it is just it's game one. This is the biggest stage they played on this season.
And a whistle inside will go against Breon January. Her first personal. And the second team foul on Indiana. Minnesota with plenty of finals experience as Moore tried to draw the foul, gets it back herself, can't finish, but Fowles can. Sylvia Fowles doing work on the glass early on. She now has six rebounds to go with her first bucket and a block.
Great sign for Minnesota that Sylvia Fowles has come to play on both ends of the floor. Stephanie White said her biggest concern was rebounding, letting Minnesota get to the offensive glass. Sylvia Fowles getting it done down there, and then a beautiful block this way.
Zealous hits, and Indiana had missed eight in a row. That finally ends with the Shavonte Zealous bucket. Going to be a physical series, as you're already seeing in the early minutes here, Rebecca. As we expected, Fowles is no one near her. And Catchings gets to her and pokes it away. January pushing pace will flip it up and draw the foul on Whalen. And Breon January will go to the line.
January, one of the quickest guards in the league, has great explosiveness as well. Very good when she can be going downhill in transition or turn the corner in the half court set. Very dangerous.
Taking a look at the series schedule, Tuesday on ESPN2. Right back here in Minnesota for game two, 8 Eastern. Then Friday in Indiana, 8 Eastern for Game 3. And if there's a Game 4, that would be Sunday on ESPN. Game 5 would be Wednesday on ESPN2, October 14th. For more on these games, go to WNBA.com or access the WNBA app. We haven't seen a long series in a while. In fact, the last 3 WNBA finals have been sweeps by the Western Conference. Indiana, the last Eastern Conference team to even win a game, as fouls traveled.
Saw Anna Cruz in the game, and she's very good pushing pace, getting in the lane, much like Lindsey Whalen can. Past 2 possessions, it's like Sylvia Fowles is very surprised that she is not
wide
more
open?
Closely guarded.
Yeah.
Yes.
She's given this space and doesn't know what to do with it right now. And that's going to be a foul or an inadvertent whistle. No indication. Yeah, it looked like a foul on Cruz. Now, Kurt Walker will say a foul on Anna Cruz.
Anna Cruz brings a little different level of intensity on the defensive end in terms of her ability to really get out and deny. You know, Lindsey Whalen intense, but she just doesn't have the same quickness on the defensive side.
Minnesota has won 10 straight playoff games here at home, dating back to that 2012 Game 1 Finals loss to Indiana. One of the best crowds in the league here. January pivoting, trying to cup it home, could not. 3 to shoot. Zellis is going to have to fire. And Minnesota controls and then tosses it right away. 4 turnovers now for the Lynx. Zellis can't hit. Larkins on the offensive rebound will give the Fever another shot. Indiana just 2 of 13 from the floor, and the number will go up with that long 2 from Marissa Coleman.
So many opportunities for Indiana on that possession. It starts with Elena Larkins getting to the offensive glass. Marissa Coleman, a player who can be streaky if she gets going. Great sign for Indiana.
Augustus out of the double, finds Fowles, and that's going to be another travel on Sylvia Fowles again. She was expecting a body on her and had space she wasn't expecting.
Part of that, she didn't look completely on balance even before she caught the ball. Your teammates have to give you the ball in a position to do something with it. I like her aggressiveness. She needs to settle down just a little bit and have a better pace when she catches the ball.
Fowles was in the finals last year as a member of the Chicago Sky, swept by the Phoenix Mercury. You know, we mentioned the Western Conference's thumpings in recent years. Since 2008, the Fever are the only Eastern Conference team to even win a game in the WNBA Finals. That's how dominant the West has been. 6-0 Indiana run. January, no, and fouls the rebound. She now has 8 in this first quarter.
She's been an absolute beast on the boards. When she has patience with her outlets and everything else, much better. Good drive by Cruz.
Ties this game at 8. Ellis using the screen from Lynetta Kaiser all the way to the cup. No, Augustus will pick it up and run. And Larkins is going to take the foul. That's not a smart one from Elena Larkins because that's her 2nd.
Yeah, you want to slow down the play, but you had another defender behind you who could have taken that foul instead.
Elena Larkins has had the best plus-minus in this postseason for Indiana, plus 35, and now she's going to have to either play with 2 fouls or sit on the bench, and it will be the bench for Elena Larkins.
Yeah, that's a foul that a veteran player generally does not commit, and that's a loss for Indiana because of her prowess on the offensive glass, her ability to defend players much bigger than she.
Meanwhile, fouls. We get to go to work on Kaiser instead. Fouls a WNBA Finals record, 8 rebounds in a quarter here in this first. Augustus misfires. Fouls was going for rebound number 9 and drew the foul on Kaiser. And immediately you see the impact of no Elena Larkins.
Yeah, she's just very good at getting her body on players, getting them out so she can get the rebound. Here you see Kaiser and Fouls both hooked up. Foul there on Kaiser. Kaiser can give you big minutes, though, on the offensive end of the floor. Very productive, very good shooter from 15, 17 feet.
Cruz using the Peters screen. seeking help, finds it in Augusta. Shot clock is at 7. Augustus will pop. No. And Moore chases down the rebound. Trying to slip it to Fowles. Knocked away. It's out of bounds off of Fowles. And another Minnesota turnover. That's their 6th.
That last possession, Natasha Howard ended up defending Simone Augustus. I'm surprised Simone did not take her off the dribble. That's a mismatch for Simone. Keep an eye on that. Talked about Simone coming back from injury. Does she have that bounce in her step to drive on the offensive end of the floor?
The entry pass knocked out of bounds. Rebecca, you think we're seeing nerves here in the early going? Each team shooting below 30%. A lot of turnovers.
For the first 5 minutes, yes, but I wouldn't expect it to last this long.
Natasha Howard will try the hook and put it home.
Credit Howard, she is long, has not been in this position before, only her 2nd year in the league, first time to the finals. That's a nice first impression when you get the ball in your hands.
Shot clock at 7. Cruz somehow slipped home the reverse.
What a bright spot Cruz has been since she came in the game.
4 points off the bench for Anna Cruz. Lynx have gotten double-digit scoring just twice this postseason from its bench, and now an offensive foul on Natasha Howard. You know, we talk about the Indiana Fever. It all starts with Stephanie White, their first-year head coach, replacing a legend and a Hall of Famer in Lynn Dunn. And she really, she's been perfectly groomed for this position, Rebecca.
Yeah, she has. Last season there were times Lynn Dunn let her take over huddles, let her run practices.
She was recruited by Dunn to play at Purdue, played a year with her there, eventually won a national championship with Purdue, then was a teammate of Tamika Catchings with the Fever, and finally found her way back as the associate head coach and now the head coach of the Indiana Fever. Fowles guided that rebound over to Cruz, and Minnesota can hold for 1. We expected a defensive battle, a physical series, and that's exactly what we've gotten in this opening quarter. Cruz has it knocked away. Zelis with 2 seconds. Zelis gets it off and can't rim it home. The first quarter comes to a close, tied at 10 apiece. This presentation of the WNBA will continue after this message and a word from our ABC stations. Maya Moore got going early, but Indiana answered, tied at 10 after 1.
To here with Indiana coach Stephanie White, and you talked about the importance of rebounding in this. So what concerns you now that Sylvia Fowles alone has 8 rebounds?
Well, we have to do a better job of putting a body on her. You know, a lot of times we're too busy looking at the ball and we forget to look at our man, and so we have to be more disciplined when it comes to boxing out.
Heard you talk with your assistants just now about matchups. What do you want to change here moving to the second quarter?
Well, we have to sub. We have to get Marissa out of the game right now. She played that whole quarter, so we want to make sure we know who's guarding Maya, how we're guarding her in certain actions that they run, and make sure our defense is on point.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, the first quarter of game 1, the lowest scoring first quarter in WNBA Finals history. Previous low was 23 combined points. Just 20, but Maya Moore hits on her first attempt of the set.
Both of these teams, strong defensive teams, except on that play where Zelis gets free. They've been effective keeping one another on one side of the floor, not allowing ball reversal. Indiana getting into their sets a little bit slower than Coach Stephanie White would like.
Shavonte Zelis been active early, 2 of 8 from the floor, 4 points. The leading scorer for Indiana. As Cruz misfires and the rebound chased down by the Fever, Zelis really burst onto the scene in the 2012 finals against Minnesota, had 30 in game 3, and then the next season went on to be an all-star and been a steady piece of the core of this Fever team since.
Player who can create her own shot off the dribble.
Shanice Johnson trying to do that there and gets the friendly roll. Shanice Johnson, much like Marissa Coleman, has found a home here in Indiana as Moore gets called for the charge.
It's one of the things that Indiana does well. And you know Maya Moore, get a little bit of head full of steam, comes in. January right there, that's the right call. Again, Brand January, very good at taking that. Maya trying to adjust and avoid the foul, but definitely the right call by the official.
Well, in Breon January, you have a four-time all-defensive team player. In Tamika Catchings, you have a five-time defensive player of the year award winner. This is an Indiana team that knows how to apply ball pressure.
They take pride in their individual defense, and they spent a lot of time in practice yesterday on their schemes. They run a variety of schemes. They double team. They make it very difficult for you to find a flow on your in your offensive rhythm.
Kaiser will pop short. Rebound ends up with Moore. Moore has Whalen to her left, flips it to her, and Whalen is smacked to the ground and will go to the line.
What Minnesota, both of these teams want to do. If they can get out and transition, they thrive in terms of that offensively. Maya Moore, as soon as she collects, she is going full speed, knows Whalen is right there. Whalen might be the point guard in the league that sort of feeds off of contact on her shots more than any other.
Meanwhile, Minnesota, led by head coach Cheryl Reeve, the best winning percentage in postseason history with a 26-8 record for any head coach. The best winning percentage in regular season history for a coach who has been head coach for a minimum of 100 games. Seeking her third championship, and she has really built sustained success here in Minnesota.
It's a culture, and she's totally implemented that here in Minnesota. Players buy into everything that she wants them to do based on defense, but also really pretty share the ball offense, fun game to play.
Inside, Zelis doesn't get the roll, and it ends up batted out of bounds by Indiana. Javonte Zelis has had some good looks, but she's now 2 of 9 from the floor.
She's not afraid of taking the shot here today.
Moore will try one. She got it. Maya Moore with 9 points. The postseason's leading scorer, leading her team in game one thus far.
After the ball left Maya's hand, Zelis kind of put her hands in the air like, what more can I do? It was good defense.
Here's Johnson wrapping around, trying to free herself of Augustus. That's a bit of a force. On the ground, Catchings ends up with it and calls a timeout. Catchings always willing to sacrifice her body for the ball, and they're able to do so and win Indiana the possession. But Maya Moore starting to cook here in the second quarter. She's given Minnesota a 16-14 lead. And sometimes, Rebecca, there's not much you can do to defend her.
We talked about Maya Moore's ability to score when the defense is right there. Zelis is right there. It's two more for Maya.
Well, voting is still open in ESPNW's quest to determine the best of the best in women's basketball, down to the Elite Eight in the bracket. And at the half, we'll get an update to vote for your final four picks. Go to ESPNW.com/bestballer. Tamika Catchings certainly in the running for best female baller during the WNBA era. Right now, Minnesota 16-14, game one lead, a defensive opening half here in Minnesota, where the Lynx have won 10 straight playoff games and are 19-2 all time. Johnson will pop and hit. Good looking stroke from Shanice Johnson.
Yeah, Shanice Johnson bringing a little bit of offense here for Indiana. She has the ability to create for herself. That time she didn't have to, found herself open.
Meanwhile, Simone Augustus has not scored yet in this game. Lindsey Whalen with just a point. They've each been battling injuries, which means even more on Maya Moore.
Part of that is Simone Augustus coming back from injury, but also she's got Breon January defending her. Can be a struggle for Simone when January's taking away what she's trying to do.
For a little more on that injury situation, let's check in with Holly.
Well, Cheryl Reeve has told us Maya Moore is not enough. She has got to have some help from people despite her 40-point games that she's been having. Simone Augustus is estimated to be at just about 65% right now. She missed part of the season with a knee procedure and then missed the last 8 games of the regular season with a sprained foot. It's either the knee or the foot. She's in pain constantly. And she told us that the week before the playoffs started, she couldn't even move laterally. That is a huge part of her game, shaking and baking, taking people to the hole off the dribble. And we see that her knees are maybe not what they should be right now.
Anything to get Holly saying shaking and baking.
Exactly.
She appropriately drops the G's, shaken and baking. That's the first rebound for Rebecca Brunson. Had a 19-rebound game in game one of the Western Conference Finals. Is the all-time rebounding leader in finals history.
Gosh, this is sloppy for Minnesota. This is a team that normally takes care of the basketball.
They have 9 turnovers, Rebecca. Coleman, sure. Leave her alone. She'll knock that down all afternoon.
2 possessions in a row where Indiana has gotten open looks, and they've capitalized on those.
Whalen having all kinds of trouble with the ball pressure from Johnson. Here's Augustus trying to go by Johnson. Can't finish. Stripped away. Moore will put it home. Augustus poked it from behind, and Moore cleaned it up. And now Moore down court. She is going to get credited with a steal and then draws the foul. What effort from Maya Moore going down court and giving her team whatever it needs right now.
Maya Moore on one end of the floor. She turns and looks. No one's running harder right now. She goes down hard, and the crowd erupts when she gets back up. It's like Maya Moore takes a point of pride. You can make me go down hard, but I'm going to come right back at you.
Well, as much as she is credited with her scoring, we have seen her make some huge defensive plays in this postseason.
Nobody wants to win like Maya Moore. I mean, she just a tremendous competitor.
And now Fowles gets loose for the lane. Sylvia Fowles with 4 points to go with her 8 rebounds. Most rebounds in a half in finals history is 10. Fowles had 8 in the first quarter. Good backdoor cut, but Chamwa just couldn't finish. Here's Moore galloping ahead. The stutter step, the leg is good. Maya Moore with 11 in the frame.
And he needs a timeout now.
They'll take that timeout as Maya Moore is starting to take over.
The momentum started to turn when Maya Moore made the defensive play, and now she's just keeping it rolling, attacking Tamika Catchings. When Maya Moore gets a head full of steam, you better watch out because she can keep it rolling. One more time, another look. Oof, talk about how competitive Maya Moore is. She took it right at Tamika Catchings, one or the other. Most competitive players we've seen in this game, and Maya continues to play like she has played this entire playoffs, consistently well, scoring, efficient on the offensive end.
Well, the 27.8 points would be the 4th highest scoring average in WNBA postseason history, and Maya Moore looking to up that number with what she's doing so far today. 15 points in the opening half, 11 of them coming in this quarter. A 5-point Minnesota lead. Maya Moore has outscored Indy in this frame 11-9. January finds Coleman on a 3. That's short. And Shanice Johnson another offensive rebound. Indiana was the top team in the WNBA from the 3-point line this year, and January draws the foul after Catchings laid a lick on Lindsey Whalen. And Whalen is still just coming to her feet after Rebecca Brunson gets hit with her 2nd personal on the drive, but that was some screen set by Catchings.
Whalen should be getting on which one of her teammates did not call that screen, because she got crushed.
Well, tonight, Priyanka Chopra stars in Sunday's new hit drama, Quantico. It's the show the press calls instantly addictive, Quantico, tonight at 10:09 Central Time on ABC. January is now 4-4 from the line. She's 0-5 from the floor, but she makes it a 3-point game. Oh. Thompson now playing with two fouls. Here is foul. Sylvia, that is. She banks it.
When she gets positioned that low on the block, she's got the size advantage. She just needs to turn around and shoot over the defender.
Six for fouls. 15 for more. Catching, spinning three, can't finish. Larkin's back in playing with two fouls. Johnson didn't flip it out with enough velocity, but January still knocks it down.
That's what happens when you give up the offensive rebound. Everybody's out of position on the defensive end. You can find an open shooter on the perimeter.
Just 1 point combined between Augustus Whalen and Brunson so far, but Moore has been that good. Fouls, and then Cruz off the bench. Foul short that time, and the rebound ends up with Marissa Coleman. Tamika Catchings yet to score in this opening half for Indiana. January starting to get cooking. Breon January with 9 points, and this game is tough.
She's a tough player. Mentally tough, physically tough. She knew her team needed her to get going in that moment, and she's been able to do it, Breon January.
Her third finals appearance, and she has tied this game at 26. 3 minutes to go in the second. Six in game one, and Kevin Garnett catching the action. The Timberwolves season about to begin, and the Timberwolves have been very supportive of the Lynx all season long. Meanwhile, sounds like Lindsey Whalen was maybe a different adjective than supportive in that last huddle, Holly.
Well, Lindsey Whalen doesn't speak a lot, but when she does, her teammates listen. She got really mad at her teammates, says, that's it, that's enough, no more offensive rebounds. Much of the damage Indiana did in that last stretch run was off of those offensive rebounds. Cheryl Reeve agreed and said, hey, sloppy closeouts, too sloppy.
Well, and Holly, to add to that, they've had six already in this first half from Indiana. That's uncharacteristic for Minnesota to allow a team to crash the offensive glass like that.
Because they have such good rebounders themselves. Sylvia Fowles, Rebecca Brunson are so used to clearing that up for their team. And as has happened throughout the course of the playoffs that we've seen, Cheryl Reeve, when they have side out of bounds plays, looking to get it into Sylvia Fowles. That last time, Fowles, three players on her, wrapping her up for that foul.
Marissa Coleman whistled for her second personal. Sylvia Fowles been very active in this opening half. 6 points, eight rebounds. Minnesota one of three from the line as a team, and now they're 2 of 4. Six ties, nine lead changes in this opening half. Catchings, nifty crossover, and the finish, first bucket of the game for Tamika Catchings.
Beautiful job on that pick and roll to split through the defenders and get to the bucket for Catchings.
Catchings, the postseason's all-time leader in points, rebounds, up there in the top two in basically every category of meaning. Moore will pop. Halfway down, no, the first miss of the quarter for Maya Moore, who was 5 of 5.
Tamika Catchings, you know Indiana likes to run a lot of on-ball screens. The defender hedges out. She splits right through for the easy two. See if that gets her going in terms of her jump shot.
Lindsey Whalen, 4 assists in this first half. Augustus, her first bucket. So now the Nets getting on the board in Augustus and Catchings. Each of these teams with 5 players who were part of the 2012 matchup. That's a long two for Catchings, no. And here comes Moore. Moore will pop. Catchings, the outlet to January. Coleman was closed out on by Augustus. Good D there from Augustus, and it's out of bounds off of Fowles. Another chance for Indiana.
Yeah, that was great defense by Simone Augustus. You have to know that Marissa Coleman, especially when you get in transition situations, looking for the three, stayed with her to contest. Coleman can be so dangerous offensively for Indiana.
She's lethal from three and shows it off there on cue.
Both game threes in the first and second round, she hit 5 3-pointers, always at key moments.
Very comfortable here in Indiana. Stephanie White has given her a lot of confidence. As Fowles misses the bank, Brunson bats it alive, but Johnson ends up with it. Indiana the two-point lead, final minute of this first half. Coleman on the block, working Whalen and putting it home.
Great job by Marissa Coleman to recognize the mismatch. Smaller Whalen on her, she goes right to the block.
9 points now for Marissa Coleman, and Lindsey Whalen will take a timeout with 47.5 seconds remaining in this second quarter. We'll step aside for a moment, have the finale of this opening half. Indiana. Well, Indiana has taken a four-point lead on Minnesota. Final second of the second quarter. Hey, gear up for the finals at WNBAstore.com now for the best selection of Fever and Lynx gear. Plus, receive free shipping on U.S. orders over $25 using the promo code WNBA25 at checkout.
I saw you on the site the other day. What was your favorite item?
There was a long, I don't know if you call it a pullover, that I really liked.
Okay.
Yeah.
Not a fleece?
Not a fleece. I'll save that for you. I know you've had one in your cart for a while.
I have.
Ryan Rucco, Rebecca Lobo, Holly Rowe with you. Our entire crew, happy you could be with us on this Sunday afternoon for game one of the WNBA Finals. Indiana on a 12-3 run to take their largest lead. It's four. The Lynx largest lead, five. It's been a tightly played opening half.
I think you called it a defensive struggle. That's what it's been, as you can see from the score.
Seven to shoot. Here's Fowles working the block on Larkins, who has two fouls, and Ketchings comes up with a rebound. 6 second difference, game and shot clock. Indiana will pull back, make sure they get a good one. January working behind Larkins, finds Coleman, another three. That one's short, more of the rebound, 6 seconds to operate. Loses the dribble, up ahead. It's Johnson underneath to Larkins, who beats the buzzer. And Indiana closes out the opening half on a 14-3 run to take a 6-point lead and quiet this Target Center crowd.
Great job by Andy to not only recognize an open teammate, but to know you have enough time to get it to her, to get the score, a little bit of momentum going in the half.
Well, Indy has a 6-point lead. Maya Moore at 15 and a half, though. She's with Holly.
Maya, you were scoring so well in that second quarter, but you've got to get some help from your teammates. How can Lindsey and Simone and others get more involved?
We just have to be more poised, keep our spacing, and keep attacking.
A little bit of a defensive lapse those last few minutes. What can you guys do better to be connected defensively?
Clean up our offense, and then we'll give our defense a chance to get set.
Thanks, Maya.
Right.
Well, a score at the half, Indiana 35, Minnesota 29. Stay tuned for the WNBA Halftime Report presented by State Farm. Doug Kazarian, Carolyn Peck will have that for you. We got a tight one in game one after two quarters of play. It's the Fever by six. Welcome back to the 2015 WNBA Finals presented by Boost Mobile. Our score, Indiana 35, Minnesota 29. Getting ready to start the third quarter, as is Indiana head coach Stephanie White.
We got 20 minutes, but it all starts with our first five. Our first 5 minutes, we set the tone. We must continue to box out. We must continue to be active on D. Push transition, y'all. They do not want to run. They don't want to run. Make shots. We're pushing in our early actions. We don't have it. We back it out.
Let's
all
go,
right?
Y'all.
It's our tempo. We dictate in the second.
Well, a tightly played first half. Ryan Rucco, Rebecca Lobo with you. And Indiana ends up on top by six. They close out the half on a 14-3 run. We take a look at how they were using ball screens. That's our State Farm BetterHelp assist.
They did such a good job, especially in that second quarter. They love to set the on-ball screen. And how are you going to use it? Well, here you see Breon January involved with Elena Larkins. These two go after it. Simone Augustus gets caught behind the screen. January pulls up. Well, here, Sylvia Fowle is going to anticipate this screen. She's going to hedge out big. Well, Tamika Catchings recognizes that, so what does she do? She snakes right through, can get to the hoop. That's where Indiana really thrives in the on-ball screen.
Time to check out today's first half stats, brought to you by SAP. Marissa Coleman, Breon January with 9 points apiece. Maya Moore, Sylvia Fowles leading the way for the Lynx, who turned it over 10 times. And Indiana made some adjustments as the first half went along to how they were defending Sylvia Fowles. Isn't that right, Holly Rowe?
Absolutely, and I was asking Stephanie White how they were going to change things defensively here in the second half, and she said the most important thing is to stay in their rotations. They don't change how they defend Maya Moore, but if Sylvia continues to heat up 7 points, 8 rebounds in the first half, like we saw right there, she is going to consider sending a double team. She said, I hate to do it because it puts us out of rotation, but we just might have to.
Great job by Minnesota anticipating that double team coming. You saw all the room that Sylvia Fowles had in the middle of the floor, but very difficult to get a second defender there. Holly.
Coleman got it to go, and Maya Moore might have gotten away with a whistle there as well. But Coleman now with 11 points. This game had 6 ties, 12 lead changes in the opening half. This 6-point margin right now is the largest either team has had. Fowles got another.
Sylvia Fowles starting this second half the way she started the game, and that's being aggressive on the offensive end of the floor, again with space, so it's difficult to crowd her.
Fowles, 11 points, 8 rebounds. In the finals, the second straight year. Last year, lost with Chicago. Acquired by Minnesota late July this year, as January, a little too strong on the three and more the rebound.
Minnesota will take that defensively because that was a very contested shot.
That is not short, though. Catchings the rebound. Tamika Catchings held to just 2 points in the opening half. She's been averaging nearly 20 a game in the playoffs after she had a career-low 13 a game in the regular season. And here, draws the foul probably on Moore. Brunson was digging. But if it's on Moore, that'll be her third. And it is on Maya Moore.
One thing we saw in the Phoenix series with Minnesota.
Check that. That'll be her second personal. They had initially marked it as her third, second, and obviously a big difference for Maya Moore.
And Minnesota got accustomed to playing with players in foul trouble in that Phoenix series. A sigh of relief from Cheryl Reeve that Maya Moore only has two and not three.
And now Catchings at the line, an 84% career free throw shooter, knocks down both. Indiana has to feel good about being able to build a lead in that first half without getting much offensively from Catchings.
They did a great job too, and Minnesota went on its run from Maya Moore to get the crowd quieted again. This crowd could play a huge part for this Minnesota team.
19-2 here all time in the playoffs. They've won 10 straight home playoff games. Whalen got it to go, fading away and knocking it down. Lindsey Whalen's first field goal of the afternoon. Johnson giving space along two, is short and Fowles able to control. Here comes Moore, bursting free. We'll flip it up with the left hand, no. And now January gonna take it the other way, 2-on-2. And she's wrapped up by Whalen.
Lindsey Whalen, doesn't seem like she's been 100% in these playoffs, but that's one thing that she can always do. You know, dribble, spin, and fade. Made a living doing that in the WNBA.
Let's check in with Holly.
But Lindsey Whalen has been battling bursitis in her heel and also an Achilles strain, but she told us that she is feeling the best she has in probably several months right before this series started, so she's feeling much better, but they do rest her, give her some time on the bench defensively.
Meanwhile, Fowles hoping she can gain a handle like Whalen, and she does, just before the lane.
Sylvia Fowles, the only player on the court who participated in last year's WNBA Finals as a member of the Chicago Sky.
And Catchings, a nice response, the bucket plus the foul.
Sylvia fouls. I mean, most big post players don't get out there and defend on the perimeter like this, and then it's not pretty. It never is when a big is going end to end, but she gathers and finishes.
Strong start to the third. Fouls with 6 points in this third, now 13 for the game. Tamika Catchings completes the three-point play. And after scoring just two in the first half, she has the last five here for Indiana.
You know, at some point, Tamika Catchings is going to come alive on the offensive end of the floor.
I'd say that's a reasonable bet. Coleman knocks it away from Moore, 3-on-2. Coleman will pull up and leave it way short. Kaiser has it stripped. Moore ends up with it. And then Moore is fouled by an over-eager Coleman. And that is going to be her third personal.
Maya Moore is just playing with so much energy and hustle here. Coleman, a little reach in to get that foul. Minnesota, I mean, Indiana has done a nice job, like right here, double teaming the player who's coming for the screen. Not a whole lot of contact on that one. January with the call.
And that is her second. Getting clarification from official Sue Blau with Stephanie White, first-year head coach.
Look at January trying to prevent Simone Augustus from even catching the ball. She is all over her.
And Augustus has to give it up. The shot clock is at three. Cruz, will she get it off? She will not. Excellent defense. You saw it, Rebecca, and January caused that whole thing.
Couple possessions in a row. You know when you catch the ball. If you're Minnesota, especially if there's a screen involved, they're going to trap you or double-team you. They make it difficult. They swarm defensively. You have to be ready for it as the player with the ball in your hands, and your teammates have to be ready to get to a place on the floor where you can see them and deliver the pass.
Here's January with Cruz trying to hawk her. January rumbling in, gets the foul call. Much to the dismay of this crowd, Breon January will be headed to the line.
It's going to be a fun matchup to continue to watch because Cruz is a very good athlete, a quick defender. We talked about it earlier, there's not many players quicker than Breon January taking it to the basket. A little bit of contact there.
Indiana shot four total free throws in the first half. They are going to have shot five already in this third quarter when January is done with her work here.
See Renee Montgomery coming into the game for the first time for Minnesota. Cheryl Reeves told us Renee Montgomery could be a big X factor in this series. A guard with good quickness. She has the ability to spread the floor by hitting the three. When she is committed, she is a solid defender.
Holly?
Well, and keep in mind that the last time that this team played Indiana, Renee Montgomery had 13.7 assists. So she has great trust in her ability to attack this Fever team right now.
And that was something Cheryl Reeve pointed out as a key game for clinching home court down the stretch as Moore pushes that one in. First point of the second half for Maya Moore. She now has 17.
That was a game that Holly was referring to where Lindsey Whalen did not play. Simone Augustus did not play. So big minutes in the starting role for Montgomery in that game.
Kaiser trying to work on fouls. The two-time defender of the year stands her ground. Cruz whirling up the floor. Right by Johnson. The kick, it's Montgomery. A little bit too strong on a throw.
Renee Montgomery has not scored well in the playoffs. That would have been a huge boost for her if she could have gotten that first shot to fall.
Zelis was 2 of 9 early in this game, has not attempted a field goal in a while. None in this third. Shot clock at 4. Catchings will heave. Around and off, fouls the rebound, and a foul will be called on Lynetta Kaiser, who went over the back. Timeout on the floor, 4:48 to go in the third quarter. Sylvia Fowles started this quarter with a burst. 6 in the frame, 13 for the game now. And how about a little coast to coast? But Marissa Coleman has been answering all game. She has 11, her team leads by 5. You're watching the WNBA Finals presented.
Growing up, my father played a huge role in my life.
From the beginning, my dad has always instilled this confidence in us that is unwavering.
In everything that we do, he tells us to do it to the best of our ability.
My dad and my stepdad really turned me into the woman I am today.
My dad and brother are so encouraging. That gives you all the confidence in the world.
Dad, thank you for believing in me and helping me believe in myself.
Indiana Fever have a 5-point lead in game one of the WNBA Finals, but Sylvia Fowles trying to bring Minnesota back.
Yeah, the rotation there just a little bit late. Fowles with some space, has great size, so able to finish inside. 3 for 3 in that third quarter. And watching a post player in transition is like watching a little kid learning how to ride a bike. You can do it, you can do it. She's able to finish it there. Great third quarter start for Sylvia Fowles.
Is that what your teammates would tell you?
Yeah, probably.
You
or no,
it,
with me they say,
it.
Stop!
Maya Moore lost it. That might hit her last. That's what Zellis thought, but it'll be Minnesota basketball. And you see the numbers for Fowles, who's boarded well today as well. 8 rebounds in the first quarter. She has 9 for the game.
Now she has Natalie Achanwa on her.
Brunson with 2 to shoot. Forces it up. No. Achanwa with the rebound. Good D again from Indy. Here comes January, who caught fire in the second quarter. The pocket pass to Achanwa, who gathers and finishes.
That's where Achanwa can be really good, because she can hit that face-up jumper, but in a pick and roll, she was so effective doing that in her days at Notre Dame as well.
Torn ACL last year. Took a while to get going this year. But a big part of the regular season for Indiana. Her minutes have been cut some in the postseason, Achanwa. But part of that is because the play of Erlena Larkins has been so good that she hasn't spent much time on the bench.
Yeah, Chano missed some time because she left twice to go play with the Canadian national team. But she can be a nice little addition, especially what do? You put Sylvia Fowles in a place on the defensive end, which is a little less comfortable. Nice finish by Chano.
7-point lead is the largest of the afternoon for Indiana. January all over Moore, and that is going to be a foul. And that's going to be number 3 on Breon January. 15 foul on Indiana, so Minnesota will shoot the rest of the way here in this third.
So important for Indiana for January to be able to continue to be in attack mode on the offensive and defensive ends.
First free throw of the game for Moore. And she misses. Hey, catch Sports Center at night with John Anderson and John Butchergross. It's a Super Sports Sunday as the guys break down week 4 in the NFL. Plus, they'll recap the final day of the MLB season. Sports Center at night tonight at 11 p.m. Eastern on ESPN and streaming live on Watch ESPN. Crazy final day, Major League Baseball, that they'll have to recap and sort out whether or not they'll be playing games or not for the AL West, for the wild card, the second one in the AL.
You'll keep an eye on your Yankees.
That's right. Zellis, a little bit short, and out of bounds off of Minnesota. Catchings and Moore were already starting on the inbound, and officials wanted to make sure the clock was right. Those are two of the best competitors that we have in the WNBA now and have ever had in this league. Montgomery able to take away the inbound. Underneath, Fowles and Achanwa were bumping. And the foul is called on Achanwa. And Indiana's over the limit, so that means Fowles goes to the line.
Ryan, you were talking about Catchings and Maya Moore. That's an adjustment here in the second half. Rebecca Brunson out of the game for Minnesota at this point, but Maya Moore getting more minutes defending Tamika Catchings than she had in the first half.
They're so respectful of each other, too. Really incredibly complimentary of each other's games. You know, Maya Moore talks about how Tamika Catchings is one of the players she's looked up to and how she wants to represent this league in the years to come the way that Tamika has.
When Maya was in college, that's the comparison everyone used, is you're the first player since Tamika Catchings who has that same motor, especially on the offensive end of the floor.
Crowd into it here. Fouls now with 8 in the quarter, 15 for the game. The lead is 4 for the Fever. Zelis lost her footing. Cheryl Reeve wanted to travel, didn't get it. January knocks it down with the towels waving.
What a shot by Breon January. Montgomery was right there. Moore was helping. Whew, nice elevation on that, Jay.
13 points for January, 4 assists, 3 boards, a whole lot of pestering defense like that. Shot clock at 6. Cruz stripped, it'll stay with Minnesota, 5 to shoot.
When Indiana's defense is really good, they turn Minnesota into a one-on-one team. A team that really likes to pass the ball, you turn them into a one-on-one team.
Augustus with a hand in her face. No. Rebound scraped up by Johnson. Cupped ahead to January. January will back it out.
That was smart because Fowles was waiting for her.
No one there as January cans another jumper. 15 points for Breon January, who has been the star of game one thus far for Indiana. An 8-point lead, largest of the afternoon for the Fever. Moore, double. Montgomery gets it into Fowles, 2 to shoot. Montgomery has to. And hits. She needed that, and they needed that.
Renee Montgomery gets her team energy, and she gives this crowd energy because she plays with tremendous emotion when her offense gets going.
5-point game. 1:30 to go in the third. Zelis and a foul will call on the shot. Now, regardless, the team foul situation would have put Zelis at the line. Montgomery called for her first personal. And Lindsey Whalen will come get Montgomery, or at least dap her up. One or the other.
Or both after the free throw, maybe.
Yeah. We'll see. Is it a substitution or a dap? Don't go anywhere. It is a substitution.
It's the doubleheader.
That's it. The old dap sub. Zelis. 5 points. And now 6. Indiana is a perfect 11 for 11 from the line. Minnesota, meanwhile, 5 of 8. 7-point Fever lead. Whalen weaving. Will force it up. No. How about another try? Looking for the body and the contact. Can't get it. Finally does and is screaming about it, saying, let's go.
Lindsey
Whalen.
Trying
to get this crowd going now.
Lindsey Whalen was seeking contact on all 3 of those field goal attempts, and she got contact on all 3 field goal attempts. Look at her. She's going into the body. She's not fading on these. She's saying, finally, I get to the line after getting fouled 3 times. But a player who, throughout her career, hasn't shown ton of emotion, so when she does, the crowd responds to it.
She is from Minnesota. She was a star at Minnesota. She's been a star here in Minnesota for the Lynx. She's 1 of 3 from the line today, though. And gets the roll there. Battling a lot more injury-wise than she or Cheryl Reeve will let on, but the heart of a champion and the all-time leader in WNBA Finals assists. 1 minute. Chanwa, give it up to Zelis, and Zelis knocks down a jumper. It's back to 8.
I don't understand why Sylvia Fowles doesn't put her hands up. A couple times when she's helped, the guards have been able to get a shot over her because her hands are down.
Whalen pushing pace. Here's Cruz on a 3. No, and Coleman the rebound. 2-for-1 opportunity for the Fever. That's what Stephanie White wants. January looking back at her. Clock waning, though, and they may not get off that 2-for-1. And now Moore knocks it out of bounds. She may be lucky she didn't get hit with a foul there.
I think she was. Maya Moore here. Yeah, I think she was. Yeah. I think there was a little bit of contact there.
You know, when you're a finals MVP and a league MVP and one of the most decorated champions in the sport, maybe you get a call or two like that.
Earn
not
that.
Shot clock at 7. Johnson on the ball fake around Augustus. Can't finish. Rebound snatched up by Crew.
But again, Sylvia Fowles' hands are down. If she just simply raises them, it becomes a much more difficult shot for the guard to finish.
Minnesota has missed 7 of its last 8 shots, and now Moore is going to go to the line, and that's just silly from Johnson and Coleman. Indiana over the limit, and so Moore will head to the stripe.
Johnson and Coleman, it sounds like a company whose product would be in the pharmaceutical aisle, doesn't
it? You think so? We won't make you answer what pharmaceutical. Hey, game 2 of the 2015 WNBA Finals presented by Boost Mobile comes your way Tuesday night at 8 Eastern on ESPN2 right here from the Target Center.
You know, like Johnson & Johnson.
Yeah, I got you.
I guess that's not really pharmaceuticals.
No, that's more like, you know, Pampin Tree.
Yeah.
Moore, this is the second free throw. And then really aggressive with Zealous. Zealous will heave at the buzzer and get front rim. She's looking back wanting a whistle from that contact from Moore. Didn't get it. Third quarter comes to a close. Indiana maintaining, even adding to its lead from 6.5 to 7 after 3. Can they steal one in Minnesota? Fourth quarter is coming up next.
Sylvia Fowles, how can you do that more here in the fourth quarter?
Well, we got to get off pick and roll. I think our guards are just messing around with the ball. Their guards are being aggressive, kind of getting to our handles. We got to get off ball screen so that she can roll. That's where she's wide open.
Also, January is starting to heat up for them. What can you change defensively against her?
Well, obviously, the action that they run for her is really hard to guard. The step-up screens, they're constantly re-screening. We're going to make an adjustment right now and see how we make out.
Big cooks.
Well, the start of the fourth quarter in Minnesota, where the Lynx have been nearly impossible to beat in their franchise history, 19-2 all time here at Target Center in the playoffs. They've won 10 straight games in postseason play. You're the last team to beat them here. The Indiana Fever, game 1 of the 2012 finals, a series the Fever won in 4. Barkins fading away, banks it up and off, and the rebound settles with Whalen. Augustus couldn't finish, but then Larkins couldn't handle. And it's Minnesota basketball. And Larkins didn't think that one bounced out of bounds. That's her frustration.
It wasn't out yet.
And that's exactly what Stephanie White's illustrating. Moore got hit. And Maya Moore will go to the line. And there's Whalen in there again trying to get her team going. Instantly with the chest bump of Maya Moore.
She has been fired up as of late in this second half. And
number 23, Maya Moore with the line.
Great job. That was almost a 5-second violation, too. Barely gets it into Maya Moore, but Lindsey Whalen wants to get this crowd back into it, too.
Moore hits the first free throw. Moore had 4 in the first, 11 in the second, just 4 in the third. So far this postseason in the fourth, she's been averaging 8.6 points a quarter, the fourth being her highest scoring quarter in the playoffs. Minnesota could use that here. January trying to turn the corner on fouls. Jeanette Poland into the game for the first time. 4 to shoot. January doesn't get the roll. Fowles couldn't handle the rebound. Now has it knocked away on the floor. It's going to be a jump. And Sylvia Fowles just flat out dropped that rebound.
So Sylvia Fowles, a good job, though, on the on-ball screen. Cheryl Reeve told Holly that she was going to change how she was defending it. It turned into a switch instead of a hedge and recover. January had to dribble through, so we'll see if Indiana can counter now. What?
Maya! Get Maya! Get behind her! Cruz! Get two together! Hold her off! Hold her off!
Larkins and Fowles will jump. That's your opening tip jump as well. Fowles is 5 inches on Larkins and wins the tip back to Augustus. Cruz and Whalen playing together, and Cruz trying to jack it up the floor. Gets it to Fowles. Then she finishes, and Stephanie White going to take a timeout. A quick start to the fourth quarter for Minnesota. They've cut it to three.
Great pick and roll play by Minnesota. They wanted to get Fowles involved, and they have.
By Boost Mobile. And in part by the State Farm National Bureau of Assists. No one assists alone.
In Minneapolis, the Fever holding on to a 3-point lead. A nice jab to begin the quarter from Minnesota, though, in this fourth. Indiana has gone to the playoffs, a WNBA record, 11 straight years now. For the fifth straight year, they were in the Eastern Conference Finals. They've been to the finals three times since 09, and in 2012, they beat Minnesota in what was an upset. And if they were to do it again this year, it would again be considered an upset. Right now, Minnesota trying to come back and take game one on their home floor. Stephanie White in Indiana trying to make sure that doesn't happen, Holly.
That's right. In that last timeout, Stephanie White told her team, look, I want us to stay aggressive. I don't want us to start playing not to lose right now. They'll make their run. We have to maintain our composure and do the things that got us here, namely ball reversal, passing to your teammates, keep them moving.
The Larkins rumbling into the rim right there. We'll get another try for Johnson. No good on a three. Catchings another attempt, and she draws the foul.
Indiana, throughout the course of the playoffs, has been at it's best when the team is in attack mode, and on that possession you saw that they weren't. Not only the initial shot, but getting to the offensive glass.
9 offensive rebounds now for Indiana. Catchings hits the first free throw. Looking at the series schedule, Tuesday game 2 on ESPN2, 8 Eastern right here in Minnesota. Friday, game 3 will be in Indiana on ESPN2. Should there be a game 4 and 5, that'll be next Sunday. And Wednesday the 14th, more on these games, go to WNBA.com or access the WNBA app.
And if there's a game, you and I will be there.
As will Holly.
Yes.
Indiana now 13 of 13 from the line, as Moore will get another crack. Here's Cruz, putting it on the floor, into Fowles. She's denied, Cruz saves it, no whistle, Moore still catches it. And that's what Maya Moore can do. Sloppy possession, it's all going wrong. No, it's not.
We've got Maya.
23 for Maya Moore, who's tied her finals high. This is the fourth final she's played in. Larkins posting Maya, denied by her. And it's gonna be a jump. Now interesting, Sue Blau called the jump. Right behind the play was Eric Bruton, who was saying play on, but Sue had a cleaner look into the action, so perhaps she thought that Larkins was locked up long enough for a jump.
Let's take one more look at it. Possession goes up. Again, I don't think there's, you know, the jump balls when two players have possession. There wasn't a jump ball.
No, I think that probably should have just been Minnesota basketball after the two denials.
That was great team defense by Minnesota. Since they've gone to switching on the on-ball screen, they've been effective defensively.
Only 2 seconds on the shot clock as Minnesota wins the tip anyway. Active crowd here at Target Center. The Lynx trailed by as many as 8 in the second half. They're within 3.
Whalen, travel. Tried to stop on that right foot and it gave out a little bit. Turnover for Minnesota.
Yeah, a little bit of frustration from Cheryl Reeve on the side. She wants her point guard to attack, but at the same time doesn't want her over dribbling in their offense.
Indy 0-6 in this fourth quarter. They have a turnover as well. Johnson. She got it. A three and the first field goal of the quarter for Indiana, whose lead is back up to six. Every time the Lynx make it a one-possession game, Indiana responds. Here's Augustus, has just 2 points, make it four.
Oh, that move is just sick. Through the legs, the floater, the runner in the lane.
And exactly what Minnesota needs right now. Ball fake from Johnson, right around, fouls for two. And Minnesota will take a timeout after back-to-back buckets from Shanice Johnson. And Cruz a little shaken up.
Simone Augustus has one of the prettiest crossovers in the game. Finishes with the floater inside. Lynx are on a charge. Fever still up by six.
Game one of the finals shaping up to be a good one. Indiana, a 6-point fourth quarter lead on the home floor of Minnesota. The Lynx adjusting to the way they've been defending the pick and roll, Rebecca.
Yeah, we'll take a look at what they were doing before the end of the third quarter. Screen is going to get set. Sylvia Files just hedging, waiting for her teammate to get there. Renee Montgomery was caught up on the screen. Now you see it, how they're defending it now. When the screen comes, it's a full-on switch. Files will jump out. Now she has got January. This is the possession that she forced her underneath the basket. It has worked well for Minnesota when it's settled into a half-court offense, and they've been able to do that defensively.
Meanwhile, Minnesota trying to get somebody going besides Maya Moore and Sylvia Fowles. They've combined for 40 of the 55 Lynx points. It's been quiet for Augustus. Brunson has not scored. Whalen has just four. Lob inside to Fowles. Her arm looked like it might have been hooked by Larkins, but instead it's a turnover for Minnesota.
And Minnesota offensively out of timeouts continues to go to the pick and roll with Sylvia Fowles. You might have to start ball faking in there though, because the help defense is on the other side of Fowles.
14th turnover for the Lynx. January finds Catchings, a three, halfway down, no, and Larkins just mistimed the landing. Augustus goes baseline and draws the foul. Simone Augustus trying to force the action in this fourth quarter, provide some help. Sam Mitchell, the interim head coach of the Timberwolves, in the building, catching the action. Let's check in with Holly.
Well, you know, something that's really cool is that he actually asked all of his players, people in the Timberwolves organization, I want you there supporting the Lynx. We saw people in the semifinals, in the Western Conference Finals, Kevin Garnett, Andrew Wiggins, a lot of players, people here supporting this team. If you think about it, they're one of the winningest franchises in this city. It is this Minnesota Lynx, and I just love it that Sam Mitchell is making sure that they are here supporting this organization.
Yeah, Kevin Garnett catching the action. His interim head coach, best wishes to our former colleague and the man who coaches and handles the basketball operations for the Timberwolves, Flip Saunders, wishing him a speedy and full recovery. As January misfires on the jumper and fouls the rebound. Crowd trying to urge it on from their Lynx. Waiting for a reason to get really excited in this fourth. Indiana trying to hold them off with fierce D. Fowles gets loose, and it's a 3-point game. Sylvia Fowles now with 19 points, 11 boards.
And when she is playing strong in the post, it's very difficult to stop her.
Johnson hesitates, hooks, denied by Fowles, controlled by Brunson. Here comes Moore. And it's knocked out of bounds by Catchings, who just swiped it away.
We talked about Sylvia Fowles played in the finals last year for the Eastern Conference for Chicago Sky. There were not times in that series where I felt like she was ready to take over. There have been spurts here in this game one where she has been ready to take over.
I'm Breon January here with a foul on the inbound. Yeah, she was trying to stay with Simone Augustus. And Augustus, you see the foul on January there. Now that's significant because it happened prior to the inbound, which means Augustus gets to go to the line here. Indiana is not over the limit. That's only their third team foul. For January, that's her fourth personal. But because it came in prior to the inbound, it means Augustus goes to the line. And she hits both. 1 point game. Indiana has led the entire second half. The lead has been as large as 8. Johnson's jumper, no good. A chance to move ahead for Maya Moore and the Lynx. Moore now with 11 rebounds. Fowles muscles inside and puts Minnesota on top. 62-61. Timeout Indiana.
Pick and roll. Simone Augustus, Sylvia Fowles, LSU to LSU. I think their teammates are enjoying what's happening on the court right now. How about KG? He's feeling it too.
Always intense, even as a spectator. Minnesota seeking its 11th straight home postseason win. They're on a 7-0 run in this fourth quarter. Well, Maya Moore and Sylvia Fowles have been quite the 1-2 punch so far in today's game one.
Well, in the early rounds of the playoffs, the 1-2 punch was Maya Moore and Simone Augustus. And today, Fowles has shown up big time.
Let's check in with Holly.
The acquisition of Fowles was crucial because Minnesota found out just weeks before the season was to start that Janelle McCarville would not return to play. So this was in the works since January that possibly they could get and trade for Sylvia Fowles, but it took a long time. Finally, July 27th, she was added to the roster, and it took almost a month for them to really get her in the flow of this team and learn how to play with her. Finally, Sylvia Fowles fitting in, coming into her own in this playoff series. A long, long process that started in January, but paying big dividends right now.
It certainly is. Rebecca, this could be the best quarter we've seen her play as a member of the Lynx.
We have seen fits and spurts of Sylvia Fowles asserting what she can do on the inside, but we have seen it here today in the biggest moments, the biggest game she has played for the Minnesota Lynx this season. Offensively, she has been powerful. Defensively, whether it's switching out or staying inside and getting the block shot, she is stepping up big in these big moments for Minnesota.
Minnesota's first lead since 29-28 back in the second quarter. And this crowd is energized, many of them on their feet. Indiana has handled raucous environments, winning 2 road game 3s in the Eastern Conference playoffs to get to this point. Coleman's 3, way off the mark. Catchings, hustling in, keeps it alive for January.
And with the way Minnesota is switching, there are mismatches Indiana can take advantage of inside, like Larkins right now with Augustus.
Instead, it's Coleman left alone as Fowles was switched on her and couldn't make it out in time.
Exactly, another mismatch. You just take the time, if you're Indiana, probe the defense a little bit, you'll be able to find an advantage.
14 for Marissa Coleman, Indiana back in front by 2. Set up for a good finish, the final 340. Game one of this best of 5 series. Cruz, a lot of dribbling and no dice at the end of that.
The play breaks down. Sylvia Fowles just needs to go set an on-ball screen.
She's slow to get back, and Johnson trying to take advantage. Larkins as well cannot. And it's out of bounds off of who? Bruton and Sue Blau converge and say Minnesota basketball. Fowles had tripped and fallen, and Indiana tried to take advantage and go right at the paint. Just couldn't finish.
It's 6'6". It takes a little while to get up.
You would know a little something about that.
Yeah. I think a little less for 6'4", but.
Yeah. I'll tell you what, you can really move at 5'10". Minnesota down two. Cruz alone. Off the mark on a three. And Indiana basketball leading by two. Cruz now 2 of 7 from the floor. Neither team has shot it particularly well. Indiana shot it at just 33%, yet they have a two-point lead. Minnesota, a less than robust 42%.
Minnesota extending their defense, still extending their defense. Takes a little bit of time away from Indiana in terms of probing those mismatches that they can get on screens.
January around the Larkin screen. January, the start and stop. Cruz hung with her nicely. Coleman, not that time. And it hit Brunson, and Ketchings wisely let it go. 5 to shoot for Indiana. It's Ketchings, Coleman, Zealous, January, and Larkins to 5 on the floor for the Fever. Coleman gets loose. Ketchings finds her. It's a 4-point Fever lead. A 5-0 response from Indiana. And a foul inside against the Fever. That'll be their 14th foul. Meaning from here forth, Minnesota will shoot.
I love when you get here forth into the telecast.
Yep. Following this, all free throws is another way to say here forth.
Not as much fun.
Moore with a hand in her face, nearly got it to pop down, and because of that last foul and the effort of Rebecca Brunson, free throws are coming for Minnesota.
And another foul on Breon January. That is her fifth. That is important for Indiana because of what she does, defensive end, offensive end. She is at her best when she's playing aggressively. She will need to be a little bit less aggressive now with those five. Rebecca Brunson's been quiet, and she played a ton of minutes in the first two rounds in the Western Conference.
She hasn't scored in this game.
And she does not look 100% healthy to me. When she's running up and down the floor, I mean, there's a little bit of a hitch when she's running, and that's something to keep an eye on, especially as we go towards game two.
She was vital in the Western Conference Finals. Well, Minnesota just 13 of 20 from the line. Indiana is 13 of 13. January weaving through traffic to the rim and finger rolls it home. Breon January with 17 points. Her team leads by 5. And after Minnesota took its first lead since the second quarter, Indiana has had a strong 7-1 response.
The Indiana organization talks about the mental toughness of Breon January, that she's right up there with Tamika Ketchings. She knows they're switching on the screen, so how do you take advantage of that? Sylvia Fowles is there. You snake, get right through, get to the basket. So now when Cheryl Reeve comes out, will she switch again the defensive scheme? Because Indiana's been able to take advantage the last few possessions.
When we talked with Stephanie White about why they've been able to pull off this run, aside from Tamika Ketchings' leadership, which is always talked about, and her ability, the number one thing she mentioned was the pace with which Breon January has been playing.
On both ends of the floor. Offensively, she pushes the ball. She gets touches in the paint. She gets shots for other players. She just stays in attack mode, and that keeps the defense on its heels a little bit. And then when she's on the defensive end, she's willing to pick up full court, or as we've seen, just get all in Simone Augustus before she can catch the basketball.
Yep. Go get a rebound. Go get a rebound. Come on, come on.
Taking a look at today's game track brought to you by Dr. Scholes. We've talked about contested and uncontested shots for Maya Moore. Well, 15 points contested, 7 of 17 from the floor. You see, Rebecca, there aren't many shots she's taken that have been uncontested.
Yeah, she doesn't get very many looks. Usually it's off of a turnover in transition where she can go the other way, but defense always focusing on Maya Moore.
And Indy is winning the starting backcourt battle 27 to 11 today. Augustus trying to change that. It's a one possession game again. Here's Catchings. 9 points, 4 assists, 6 rebounds today for Tamika Catchings. January, using the Larkin screen, frees herself, and hits another.
And a great job and a great read, because on the initial screen, Minnesota had gone back to not switching. So what happens? January gets the rescreen and takes advantage.
Moore is switched on January now. Here's Fowles trying to find Moore. That's going to be a foul on January, and that'll be number 6. And January is irate, having to be held back by her teammates. She might get a technical as well, and I think she did.
I understand the frustration, but you have to understand, as a player, you can't do anything that gives the official the opportunity to call a technical foul on you in this moment. Maya Moore with a big-time acting job. I understand January's frustration.
That is one of the more underrated parts of Maya Moore's game. She knows how to sell calls. There was a little bit of contact there with the forearm on the back.
Not enough to create what Maya did. But the bigger point to me is, January, you can't react like that. You can't. This moment is too big. You have a chance to win on the other team's home floor in game one.
And now it's going to be 3 free throws for Maya Moore. Indiana's over the limit, and Maya Moore is straight cash at the line. 86% career free throw shooter. She has missed a pair today. Not that one. You also wonder, Rebecca, you know, Breon January, as much as she has been as big a part of this game as anybody, she doesn't necessarily have the big player reputation to get the benefit of the doubt on a 6th foul call, where the officials might say, it's going to have to be a little bit more for me to knock her out of the game.
And most of her fouls, as Maya Moore misses a free throw, most of January's fouls came off the ball, trying to deny Simone Augustus or another player from getting the catch.
Minnesota now just 14 of 22 from the line. That's 63.5%. Moore hits 2 of 3. Her finals high, 25 points. It's back to a one-possession game, Indiana by 3.
And now Catchings becomes the primary ball handler, bringing the ball up the floor for Indiana.
And you can see Cruz is going to apply more pressure. Final minute of game one. Zealous turning the corner, laying it up, and in! Big-time bucket by Shavonte Zealous to give Indiana a 2-possession lead again.
Shavonte Zealous has struggled in this game offensively. She's not a natural point guard, has played that position when January has had to go out during these playoffs. What a great job to turn the corner, get past Cruz just a step, and to finish.
Now Minnesota down 5 with 1 timeout remaining. And Maya Moore, doing her work mostly at the line in this fourth quarter, has not gotten a ton of good looks here down the stretch.
Last time they came out of a timeout, Cheryl Reeve drew up the play for Simone Augustus. You would think they would want Maya Moore to at least get a touch, but you got plenty of good options on the floor right now. Augustus, Moore, Sylvia Fowles inside.
No Lindsey Whalen on the floor right now. Instead, it's Anna Cruz handling the point. Bit of an anxious Target Center crowd, where Minnesota is 19-2 all-time in the playoffs. Lynx down 5. Augustus, no good, rebound, poked home. Fouls and Moore will there. We'll see who they give the credit to. It's 2 on the board for Minnesota regardless, and it's 2 more for Maya Moore. She has 27. And now the Lynx need a stop. 30 seconds remaining. 7 on the shot clock. Zealous having trouble with Cruz. Zealous short. The rebound out of bounds off of Indiana. Minnesota basketball with 19.3 to go in this fourth quarter.
And if you're Minnesota, you absolutely do not need a three, especially because Indiana's primary point guard is out of the game.
Get you higher, though. Cruz, back screen. Still. Okay, higher. Throw to Still. Come by for this handoff. Let's make the play. Right? If we don't score, get a foul. We want to foul Larkin.
Now Indiana has not missed a free throw today. They're 13 of 13. Larkin's a 70% career free throw shooter, 68% this season. But everybody else on the floor for Indiana, a very good free throw shooter.
And Larkin's has been 86% in these playoffs. But as we said, Minnesota can look to attack, get a quick two, and then try to wreak some havoc defensively again without January on the floor.
January, the best ball hawk that Indiana has. A tremendous performance, 19 points, 6 assists, 4 rebounds. She's fouled out. Moore will trigger in with Brunson fouls. Cruz and Augustus on the floor for Minnesota. Down 3 here in game 1, 19 seconds to go. The handoff knocked away. Fouls trying to get it back on the floor. It's a jump.
Maya
and
saw
a little miscommunication there with the handoff between Fouls and Moore.
Well, Maya saw the defender right there, so she quick was going to go the other way, but Fouls didn't recognize that. Good job by Coleman to get her hand in there. You have to be able to read your guard and know how she's using that.
Now Renee Montgomery is going to come get Rebecca Brunson.
This is for defensive reasons after Cheryl Reed hopes that they score.
These two have jumped twice already today. Each is 1-1. The third jump between Larkins and Fouls. Fouls knocks it back to Moore. Ketchings pokes it away. Ketchings on the break will peel out and be fouled by Maya Moore. And that is a savvy, slick defensive play by one of the all-time greats, Tamika Ketchings, to knock it away from Moore and then a wise one to back it out. Minnesota had a foul to give. So Indiana will have to inbound. Zealous looking to inbound. And a foul away from the ball is going to be on Minnesota and Maya Moore.
That's before it was inbounded, correct?
Yes.
That's before it's inbounded. You get the free throw and then you get the ball back.
Yes, yeah, so
see if the ball's out of the inbounder's hands. Nope, the foul. So Indiana gets a free throw, and then they get possession of the basketball.
They get one free throw, and then ball. Ketchings, 5 of 5 today from the line. Make it 6 of 6. Indiana as a team is 14 of 14.
It's the difference in the game. Free throws have been the difference in the game.
Minnesota has missed 8 free throws, Indiana none. And Ketchings is going back to the line. And this place is about as quiet as you will ever hear at this time of year. They are not used to seeing their team down in the waning seconds of a fourth quarter.
We're down in a playoff game. 19-2 at home in the playoffs.
Minnesota without timeouts. And Ketchings hits another. 15 of 15. The Fever from the line. Trying to become the fifth team in finals history to be perfect from the stripe. Ketchings hits another. It's a 6-point game. Montgomery will give it up. Cruz gives it up as well. And that will do it. Indiana steals game 1 in Minnesota. 75 to 69 the final. A terrific defensive performance from the Fever, who were able to limit Simone Augustus, Lindsey Whalen, and Rebecca Brunson all to single-digit scoring. Big performances by Maya Moore with 27 and Sylvia Fowles with 21. But a complete team effort from Indiana. 16 from Marissa Coleman, 12 from Tamika Ketchings, 10 apiece from Shavante Zealous and Shanice Johnson, and then 19 from Breon January. And January did a little bit of everything today, Rebecca.
She was just so tough on both ends of the floor. Draw the tough defensive assignment on Simone Augustus was all over it. Quickness, toughness. She stays in the play. She is disruptive on the defensive end. And then offensively, her explosiveness, her quickness. She recognized when Minnesota was switching the way they were defending the pick and roll. She continued to probe. She made big shots. Great performance today by January.
And she is standing by with Holly Rowe.
This is a very difficult building to come in and take game one of the finals. What were the keys to your team getting it done on the visitors' home floor?
Just staying focused and staying locked in and staying together. You know, and we knew they were going to go on runs. They're a great team, and they're going to continue to punch throughout the game. But if we stayed united the entire 40 minutes, we knew we had a good chance to pull it out. And I'm so proud of my team tonight.
How do you describe the attack mentality that your team was on all night?
Well, you have to against a great team like that. If you let up for 1 minute, they're going to capitalize. And so we had to maintain that attack mentality throughout the whole game, taking it to the rim, whenever they scored, punching back at them, all that, the entire game. Yes, and like I said, I'm just so proud of my team.
What was going through your mind when you foul out with just a few seconds left and then you get the technical?
You know, I need to keep my composure. I know that for my team. You know, that's extra points for them, but I had complete faith in my team that they were going to finish it out. We have such a great core, and they were out there on the court at that time, and I knew they were going to pull it out for me, and they did.
I covered you in that 2012 finals against this team. You've changed. You were much more aggressive as a point guard. How have you grown tonight?
Well, you know, just trying to be aggressive and trying to be a leader on this team. I know I've been in the league for a few years now, and Tamika can't do it on her own. So myself, Shavonte, Erlena, that same core that was there in 2012, we're really looking to step up and help her.
We'll see you Tuesday night.
Okay, thank you.
Well, big performance from Breon January. 19 points, 6 assists, 4 rebounds. You take a look at her regular season and playoff numbers and how today was quite the boost. Marissa Coleman, also a terrific day, 16 points and some big buckets for Indiana. She's with Holly.
Well, Marissa, this is your first playoff finals game with this Indiana Fever team. How were you able to make such a big contribution today?
Just being focused and being ready. Just I felt like Christmas Eve last night, getting ready, you know, just so excited for this game. And they've all been here, a lot of these players before, so just them always in my ear, keeping me calm and just telling me that they have confidence in me.
I feel like your own confidence in your three-point shot is sky high right now. What are you thinking when you're going up hitting those crucial shots?
I mean, as a shooter, when you see a couple go in, it's just like Pandora's box opens for you. So just, you know, throughout the playoffs, I've been hitting a lot and just keep shooting and I know they'll fall.
You had a difficult defensive assignment tonight on Maya Moore. How were you able to take that in hand?
Just coming to this game, I knew, you know, that was my matchup. She's a great player. She's going to get shots. I just wanted to limit her touches and just try to make every shot, make sure she had a hand in her face.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, Marissa Coleman with a strong response. When Minnesota took its first lead since the second quarter, late in this fourth, it was Coleman who hit a three and then a layup in Indiana, never turned back. And this is rare, Rebecca, because Minnesota had won 10 straight games on their home floor here and had not lost since game one of the finals back in 2012. Tamika Catchings was on that team leading them, and no surprise that she's on the next team to beat Minnesota at home.
On January, your point guard just told me Tamika can't do it by herself. So what encouragement do you have that it was such a balanced effort from your group tonight?
Yeah, I just told everybody what I need from them individually, what I need from them. And I told Bree, I need you to lead. I need you to be a leader for this team. You're our point guard. Everybody's looking at you. How you start the game is how we're going to flow through the game. It's not about me. You know, everybody's going to play with the passion that I have. Everybody knows how inspiring and motivated I am to be out here and play. But I think every single person individually came out tonight and stepped it up big time.
How important is this for the series to get a game one win on their floor?
It's important. I mean, we have two games here and then, you know, we'll go back home. But our main goal was let's get one of these. Let's steal one of these, take it back home and see what we can do on our home court. So tonight, I mean, everybody came out, like I said, focused. Everybody was ready to go. It's going to be, I told him, it's going to be even more intensified next game. It's going to be harder. It's going to be more physical. You know, we're going to have to make sharper cuts. We're going to have to do a much better job keeping our composure. But we'll be ready.
Thank you, Tamika.
Thanks, Holly.
All right. Well, Indiana takes game one, 75-69. Taking a look at the series schedule, Rebecca. Game two will be Tuesday here in Minnesota. What are the Lynx going to have to do to respond?
It's going to be crucial. They need to get some more production from their point guard position. They need to get a little bit more from Simone Augustus. Maya Moore is doing everything she can. Sylvia Fowles did a great job. They need to figure out exactly which defensive scheme is going to continue to work. But most importantly, they need to make their free throws. That was the difference in the game here tonight. Indiana made all of their free throws. Minnesota missed 8. That would have been the difference.
Indiana 75, Minnesota 69. The Fever lead this WNBA Finals best of 5 series 1-0. Maya Moore did everything she could, 27 points and 12 boards. But Marissa Coleman with some big buckets. And Indiana, always tough. They've won 2 road game 3s to get here. And they win a road game 1 to take a 1-0 series lead. For Rebecca Lobo, Holly Rowe, and our entire crew, I'm Ryan Rucco. Goodbye from Minneapolis. Now let's head back to our studios.